Hi guys, this is Ian, and in today's video tutorial, I'm going to be teaching you how to play the song Wake Me Up When September Ends by Green Day. Now, for those of you who are seeing my tutorials for the first time, usually in my tutorials I cover five things, and these are I give you simple chords, simple strumming patterns, I demonstrate the entire song using the chords and the simple strumming patterns, I step you through the entire song to show you where the chords fit with the lyrics, and then I give you some additional beginner tips which I feel could be useful or helpful to you. Okay, so that's basically what's covered in these tutorials, and with that I'll just quickly get started. So for this particular tutorial, it uses five main chords, but later on at the end I'll teach you how you can actually play this song with just four chords, alright, if you really need to or want to. So it uses five chords for now, and these chords are G major, D major, E minor, B minor, and C major. Okay, so those are the five chords. And the strumming pattern which you use for this tutorial, if you're a complete beginner and you're not comfortable doing upstrokes yet, what you can do is you just use this downstroke strumming pattern where it goes down, 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 down. And this is a common strumming pattern which I use in a lot of the tutorials. So if you learn this one, you can use it in the other tutorials as well and for other songs. So basically it goes down, 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 down. And if you were to play that with the song, it would sound something like this.
Summer has come and passed. The innocent can never last. Wake me up when September ends.
Okay, so that's what it would sound like if you're playing in the song. The other one, strumming pattern I'll teach you is a bit more advanced. Basically, it has an upstroke. For those of you who want to practice your upstroke as well, you can try this one. It's very similar to the first one, except the only difference is for one part where you do a downstroke, you replace it with a down upstroke. Okay, so instead of going down, 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 this other strumming pattern goes like this: down, 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 down. And the way that sounds if you're playing in the song would be like this.
Summer has come and passed. The innocent can never last. Wake me up when September ends.
Alright, so that's how this other strumming pattern goes. So for this tutorial, I'm going to be using the more intermediate strumming pattern to demonstrate the song, because that one will probably need a bit more observation, but feel free to use a simpler one if you're not comfortable with that, and to progress to the more advanced one once you feel comfortable. Alright, so now I've shown you the chords, the five chords, G, D, E minor, B minor, and C, and the two strumming patterns. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to step you through the entire song, well, I'm going to demonstrate the song, and after that I'm going to step you through the entire song to show you where the chords fit. Alright, so with that, before we get started, as usual, I'd like to apologize if I make any mistakes with the song. Sometimes, because I only do my tutorials in one of two different song keys, and sometimes these keys are too high or too low for me, which makes it hard to sing. But anyway, I do apologize if I do make mistakes, but use this as a demonstration to see where the chords and the strumming pattern all fit together in the song. Okay, so without talking too much, we'll get into it. So basically what you do for just a simple introduction is you play the chords in the first verse once, and then you go into the verse, and then you start, okay?
Wake me up when September ends. Like my father's come to pass, 7 years has gone so fast. Wake me up when September ends. Here comes the rain again, falling from the stars, drenched in my pain again, becoming who we are. And as my memory lives, we'll never forget what I lost. September ends. Ring out the bells again, like we did when spring began. Wake me up when September ends. Summer has come and passed, the innocent can never last. Wake me up when September ends. Like my father's come to pass, 7 years has gone so fast. September ends.
Okay, so that's how the chords and the strumming pattern would all fit together with the song. Alright, so with that, the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to step you through the entire song to show you where all the chords fit. Alright, so the song can be broken up into a few basic sections. You have your intro, you have your verse and your chorus and your outro. Okay, so let's say four main sections for the song. So basically, for the introduction, what you do is you play a loop of the verse, the chords you play in the verse, and then you go into the first verse. So these chords are basically, for the introduction, you'll be playing G, D, E minor, G, then C, and then G. Okay, so those are the chords you play for the introduction, which are the same as the verse. So going through the first verse, it goes G.
Summer has
D.
Come and pass.
The E minor.
Innocent can G.
Everlasting C. Wake me up when September, then G ends. Okay, so this C drags on twice as long as the other chords. And then you go into this next part of the verse, G.
Like my father's D, come to pass,
E minor.
7 years has G gone so fast,
and C.
Wake me up when September G ends.
And then from here you go into a chorus where it's E minor.
Here comes a,
then B minor.
Rain again,
then C.
Falling from the
G
stars,
then E minor.
Drenched in my
B minor.
Pain again,
then C.
Becoming who we,
then D.
And
then into, and then next line is G.
As my
D. Marie
rest,
then E minor.
But never forgets,
then G.
What I lost,
then C.
Wake me up when September G ends.
Okay, and from here you go into the second verse where it's quite similar to the first verse, but the second part of the second verse is different. Okay, so I'll call it the second verse. So as usual, it starts with G.
Summer has D come and pass,
the E minor.
Innocent can G never last,
and C.
Wake me up when September
G ends. Then the next line.
Ring out the
D
bells again,
E minor.
Like we did when G spring began,
then C.
Wake me up when September
G
ends.
Then into the chorus, E minor.
Here comes a
B minor.
Rain again,
then C.
Falling from the
G
stars,
then E minor.
Drenched in my
B minor.
Pain again,
then C.
Becoming who we,
then D.
Are,
then G.
As my memory,
Marie
rests,
then E minor.
But never forgets
G.
What I lost,
then C.
Wake me up when September
G ends. And from here you go into the solo, which is basically the same chords for the chorus, for the first part of the chorus. So
when September ends,
and then you just play the chorus but without any singing. All right, the first part of the chorus. So it goes E minor,
dun, 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 dun.
B minor.
Dun 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 dun
dun C.
Dun 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 dun
dun G.
Dun 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 dun
dun E minor.
Dun 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 dun
dun B minor.
Dun 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 dun
dun C.
Dun 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 dun
dun D.
Dun.
And from here you go into the last verse and into the outro and finish the song. So it's G.
Summer has D come and pass.
The E minor.
Innocent can G never last,
and C.
Wake me up when September
G
ends.
Then the outro where you go G.
Like my father's,
then D.
Come to pass,
then E minor.
7 years has G gone so fast,
and C.
Wake me up when September
G
ends.
And then you repeat the last line.
C. Wake me up when September G ends.
And then the last line, where you can do what I did and just play one chord.
Wake me up when September G ends.
Okay, so that's basically the entire song, where the chords fit with the lyrics. So with that, I'll just give you some quick additional tips which you can use. So let's see, I mentioned earlier that I would show you how to actually play the song with just four chords instead of five. So that tip is basically, instead of, some of you may still have trouble playing B minor and you may not want to play it. So what you can do is you can actually play, instead of playing B minor, just replace it with D major. It won't sound absolutely right, but you can still get away with it through the song if you just use D. For example, if I was to go through a chorus where it goes, instead of playing B minor, I play D, it would sound like this.
Here comes a rain again, falling from the stars, drenched in my pain again, becoming who we are.
Alright, so it doesn't sound as good without the B minor, but it still sounds okay. So instead of playing B minor, you can just skip the whole B minor and just play D, okay? So that's one tip on how to actually make the song easier. Another tip is to actually replace the four remaining chords, G, D, E minor, and C, with simpler chords. And these chords, instead of playing G, D, E minor, and C, those of you who have trouble with doing chord changes, these are chords for you, okay? So what you'd want to play is G, D sustained 4, E minor 7, and C at 9. Okay, so G, D sustained 4, E minor 7, and C at 9. So the reason why you'd want to use these chords is, if you can see, my fingers do not move very much when I'm playing these chords. As in, these stay rooted and these move around. So it's a lot easier for those of you who have problem doing chord changes while you're strumming. So it's a good sort of training wheels to help you build up rhythm, get used to doing basic chord changes before you advance to more complicated stuff, okay? So if you didn't catch those chords, don't worry. They're in the tutorial notes. And if you're on the website, you can refer to the tutorial notes below and to the chord reference list, which is on the right side of the site. And also, if you are on the YouTube channel, refer to the description below for a link to the website and also a link to the tutorial notes for this particular tutorial. Okay, in the tutorial notes, I cover the chords and the strumming pattern, and also I list down the chords for each section of the song. All right, so those are in the tutorial notes. So replace. So as I was saying, sorry, I got a bit sidetracked. Instead of playing G, D, E minor, and C without the B minor, you can play G, D sustained 4, E minor 7, and C at 9. So just quickly demonstrate what that sounds like. It would sound like this.
Summer has come and passed. The innocent can never last. Wake me up when September ends.
Okay, so it sounds okay. It sounds pretty good and can even make the song sound better in some cases. So remember those chords. And also, let's see, the original, these chords are the chords which are used in the original song, so you can actually just play this song without the help of a capo with the original song, okay, which is in the key of G. So yeah, with that, those are basically all the main tips I have for you for this particular song. Again, if you are an absolute beginner and you still have trouble with the fundamentals, feel free to go to the website and check out the free beginner's guitar course which is there. If you're on the YouTube channel, the link is down below in the description. And also, if you want to learn any more other song tutorials, the other tutorials which I make, I have a list which is on the website. And if you're on the channel, the link is down below in the description box below. So click on that and it will take you to the page where you can try out all the other video tutorials which I've made so far. And also, let's see, so if you want to keep in touch, if you want to stay updated to new videos which I make, please feel free to subscribe to the channels, to the channel, so that you are notified every time there's a new upload. And also, if you have any feedback, please feel free to contact me to either by contacting me through the YouTube or through the contact form which is on the website. I always look forward to feedback, and if you have any song requests, please feel free. I can't always promise that I will get to the song requests, but I will always try whenever I have time to actually go through them and to actually create the tutorials. Okay, so with that, thanks for watching, good luck with your practice, and just remember, like everything, it takes persistence. I try to make it as simple as possible so that you can start playing as quickly as possible, but you still have to get down and do the work. Okay, so with that, thanks for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video tutorial.